what a treat it is. My name is Grant Kirkby. I'm a senior sales rep at oOh. I've been in the industry about 8 years. So I'm just going to kind of go through about 7 or 8 Google images that I found that kind of describe each stage of my career. And then talk about some stories along the way, and then just give some tips and learnings I've found, and you know what the future holds for me. So, I graduated from university. Pretty sure I never wore one of those hats, but I went to UCS, Bachelor of Business, majoring in marketing and finance. I've literally never used my degree ever, because I'll explain what I got into, but I've never used any of my degree at any stage of my career, which is fine. It was a great 3 years. I met a lot of cool people and had a good time. So that's really all I got out of uni. I actually, straight after uni, I actually worked as a like office junior in a creative agency, Saatchi & Saatchi, which is basically filling up the beer fridge and I don't know what else I did, just stuff around the office. I worked that while I was at uni, so as like kind of part-time job. So when I finished uni, I actually worked in a creative agency. I got into account service. So this is in about 2002, 2003. I got into account service working on Westpac. So it was good learning over the year, met some cool people and learned how, you know, the account service guys deal with the clients and how they deal with the creative teams and the production guys who are making the ads and all that kind of stuff. So it was good. It was a good year working there, but it wasn't really my thing. So I took off and did a bit of traveling. I definitely didn't wear Euro shorts like that guy. But that was an amazing year. It was great because I matured a lot as a person. I learned how to make friends and you know, create relationships quickly. And you know, you're traveling from country to country and just meeting random people and you're best buddies with them. Like literally 5 hours after you meet them. You know, it was a great year. I did mature quite a lot over that year, so I definitely wouldn't ever want to take that back. So I came back from Europe late 2004. I had no money. I had no idea what I wanted to do with my career. Luckily, I had a couple of good buddies who worked in Universal McCann. Matt McCann and... who's not a son of the McCann, just randomly, that's his name, and Cam Levy. Both those guys, they actually got me a job at Icon by throwing up my CV, and I kind of just fell into a job there, like, just, you know, it was very nice of them. The good thing, those two guys, so just a bit about future, they were like junior buyers at the time, maybe like a year or so in the industry, so probably have 9-10 years experience now. One of them actually runs the Unilever account, which is an $80 million account at Mindshare, that's Matt. And the other guy is actually running a team of 30 strategists over in the most prestigious creative agency in America, Goodby Stilkerson. So he's like the head of all strategy in this massive creative agency. And they're guys who, you know, got their foot in the door in media agencies, when now, you know, had a couple of years in media agencies and just, you know, saw what was out there and went for it. So early media career. So I got the job at Icon. I started doing, you know, all the assistant stuff, and then started doing TV buying and press buying for clients like Goodman Fielder and Vodafone. And the reason I put this up there is because the Buddha photo is because early in my career, as you guys will probably be experiencing right now, there's a lot of there's a lot of opportunity to booze, to eat. The ACP mag reps come in and give you cookies and chocolate-coated strawberries, and there's beers every Friday, big boozy Thursday night parties, and yeah, I turned into a fat bastard. I put on about 10, 15 kilos in the first year. It didn't help that one of my clients, Uncle Toby's, dropped a pallet of the snack that kind of lived next to my desk for about 6 months before I ate them all. Yeah, that was great. But so I learned a lot along the way, like through my own mistakes, which there was a lot of, and also through people I work with mistakes, most notably a guy called Carl Zeddens, who I don't know if anyone from is from Icon here, but other than Ali. But he was my first boss at the time. I started as assistant, and he'd just come over from New Zealand. He came up to me one day, and he's a pretty confident guy, Kiwi. Thinks he's awesome. He's actually one of my best mates now, but he came up, oh man, I'm absolutely killing this snack buy. So he's doing a TV buy. I'm pretty sure I'm the greatest TV buyer of all time. I'm like, oh yeah, sweet. He's like, I barely spent any cash, and I'm absolutely killing it. Like, I spent like 70% of the money, and I'm killing the tasks. The reach appearance is awesome. I'm like, oh yeah, cool. Mate, you're awesome. He goes, yeah, I'm pretty sure I'll be CEO in about 4 weeks. So I was doing his post-analysis like any good assistant does next week, and I'm looking at, and I'm running all the tasks, and I'm like, Carl, mate, I don't know what you're talking about. This buy is like a quarter of what it should be. He's like, mate, you can't be right. Have a look. I look on his screen, he's like, killing it. And I'm like, I look through the demo, I'm like, you know you've been buying this against grocery buyers without kids, and it should be against grocery buyers with kids. Oh, it's 2 weeks into a 3 week campaign. He's pretty much given the money back to the client, saying how awesome he is, and he's killed it. Had to make the call, get the money back. So yeah, you make mistakes, but it's all good. Things, you know, you learn from your mistakes. So if you ever make a mistake, all good. Don't worry about it. Early career travel. So after about kind of 2.5-3 years at Icon, I asked them for like 4 months off, and for some reason they gave it to me. I don't know why, but I went and travelled again. That's my big passion in life. Big travel through South America, do all that kind of stuff. And luckily, when I came back, Icon had just won Coca-Cola as an account. This is back 2007, somewhere about then. So I came back and I went straight into like a buying role onto that. Resumed my media career, became a fat bastard again, like this old mate. This is when things kind of, you know, changed for me. Like, I wasn't just working on a client that I was buying TV and press. Things had already been negotiated. I started getting a bit more interested because there was, you know, there's a lot of outdoor. There was online, there was like TV sponsorships that I could negotiate. It was just a little bit more exciting for me. So I worked on that for a bit, then actually moved over to Mindshare. I'd been at Icon for about 4 years by then. I just wanted a bit of a change and saw a good opportunity. One of my good mates over at Mindshare offered me a job. So I went and worked over there on clients like Diageo, LG, Sega, things like that. So quite fun brands, and the great thing about that is that opened my eyes up a lot as well. Like, I was doing a lot of outdoor negotiations, which obviously I'm in now, so I loved it. And also like TV sport sponsorships, and so for Johnny Walker we sponsored the cricket, so I, you know, do all negotiations with Channel 9. Also Bundy sponsored the NRL, so they're all part of Diageo. So I was really, really enjoying my career. Then came a bit of a career crisis. I was kind of thinking, do I really want to, I don't know what I want to do. Do I want to stay in agency? I kind of just fell into the job, and now I'm working my way up. Like, where to now? Like, is it, you know, do I want to come the CEO of Icon or Mindshare, or do I, you know, what should I do? And it was kind of about then that one of my good mates who had, I'd originally worked under Icon, Nathan Moon, who's now actually my boss at oOh, he kind of told me, you know what, mate, like, and he'd swapped into sales, and he's like, you know, the big thing for me was when I realised that, you know, being in media buying and, you know, pulling together all your plans, coming up with great ideas, you know, multimedia strategies and selling into your client, you're essentially in sales. And I was like, yeah, you're right. Like, and I actually think I was quite good at that. So I thought, well, I may as well give sales a go. So I jumped over the dark side to sales. I worked at a smaller out-of-home company for about a year and a half, and I've been at oOh for about 7 months now. Absolutely love it. And I'll just get into, yeah, sales. Loving it. So just some tips that I'll just go through that, you know, hopefully you guys learn a little bit from. A couple of you guys take some stuff out of it, then great. travel as much as possible early in career, I think. It gets a bit harder later if you have kids or you're deep into a role, it's hard to get out. But early in your career, get it out of the way so you don't have any regrets. That's what I've traveled 3 times within my career, so get it out of the way. It's a pretty crucial thing. It matures you as a person as well. Promote yourself. No one else is going to do it. So if you do good work, just make sure you tell everyone about it. And you don't want your boss claiming it. You may as well claim it for yourself. Change the clients that you work on. This is more for agency guys. Change the clients that you work on every 2 years. It'll help you, develop your career and all that kind of thing. So say you're a TV buyer, like on a TV buying client within an agency, or an online specialist, then I recommend, maybe putting your hand up for another role where you can buy, a different, broader range of, like, out-of-home radio, all different things to, give you a bit of breadth of knowledge. And, if a great job pops up where it's managing, a client with all these different media you might not have experience with, you might not be ready for that role, but if you've worked across a whole different range of media buying, then you're eligible for that. Find a role and stick with it, at least for a couple of years. Take advantage of all the perks the industry has to offer. Like, there's a lot of cool stuff out there, lunches, site tours, all the parties, take advantage of it. Although just, keep it work-life balance. Try and hit the gym every now and then. Get out to lunch, as Nick mentioned. It's pretty crucial keeping a work-life balance. That's probably the one regret I have, is early in my media career, I'd worked till 8, 9, 10 at night, a fair bit. And that's literally ridiculous. It's not sustainable. Try and get out of there at 5 or 6 if you can. Get in 8 or 9. And develop strong relationships. I've got a lot of good buddies over the years that I've developed good relationships with, that's helped me in sales. And help me get jobs in sales, help me change job in media buying, all that kind of thing. So, and the best way to do that is through developing trust. So learnings, time management. I was pretty terrible at time management early in my career, but I had a couple of good bosses that kind of taught me how to do it properly. So making lists and prioritise the most important things first and you'll start meeting those deadlines if you're not already. Some people are good at it naturally, but I know I wasn't. Great experience seeing how the industry works from a whole different point of view. So creative agencies, media agencies, sales side, it definitely helps me in sales understanding what the pressure points are for a media buyer when I get briefed, know how maybe his client's paying them, what's important to them, really understanding that helps me structure the deals and I tell you what, it definitely helps win deals as well, knowing that kind of information. And then you really get that real win-win situation out of it, either side, understanding what each other want. Know where your product fits in relation to competitors, and knowing your point of difference. Like, I know why oOh is, better in certain things than I, and why it's better than APN, blah, blah, blah. Make sure you work for something you really believe in. Like, I moved across to oOh Media because I bought their products, I knew all about their products, and I was already sold in before I started. So it makes it a lot easier for me to then be passionate to other people and make them, make them think along the same lines as me. Another good learning, I guess, is be a good listener. Particularly for sales guys, when you're receiving a brief, try and extract all the information you can out of them. Keep asking questions, listen to everything they have to say, write it all down. And there might be some little point, and not every time, but occasionally get a crucial little bit of information that someone else doesn't have that will help you win the deal. My current role is pretty much just stay top of mind and remain relevant. That's me as a person and also the company I'm representing, oOh. Keep up to date with all the client strategies, whether that's day-to-day calls and all that kind of thing. Create and maintain relationships. Lunches are the greatest thing ever for that. Structuring deals, which I love, ensuring clients are aware of all our points of difference, informing them of new products and developments, and obviously hitting sales targets is a pretty crucial part of my role. Day-to-day sales, maintaining the contact, doing the deals, keeping up to date with clients, meeting, presenting all our responses, and any, you know, product development and lunches. So, likes, I love all that relationship building. A lot of good buddies in the industry. That's pretty much my favorite part of the job. Structuring your deals and being strategic about how you can win certain sales. Coming up with cool ideas. Well, I'll show you one in a sec with some work that I'm proud of. The office banter, it's good to stick with a company you really love, and you get on with everyone around you. Lunches, winning deals, love all that. I dislike losing deals. I'm a little bit competitive. So I think it's probably the one thing I can say to a couple of the young sales guys out there is you win some, you lose some. Like, yeah, I know it hurts quite a lot when you lose a deal, but you just got to get on with it. The buyer's just doing what they think's right. You just got to get on with it and say, cool, no worries, you're a legend. See you next deal, you know. So, and cold calls is something that I always kind of don't look forward to, but you just got to punch them out. And, you know, it's probably more for the new guys because over a period of time, you start to know everyone, so you don't really make any cold calls. But occasionally, you have to make them, and you know, you don't look forward to them, but they're all right. But I guess the key thing there is all the guys in agency know that as sales guys, it's part of their job to know what's out there. So they generally are pretty good about you calling them and asking for a meeting or asking questions because, you know, that's part of the industry. So here's something, I better go back. Sorry. So the next one is actually some work that I'm proud of. We got a brief from a alcohol brand. They wanted to own a landmark. They wanted to own a landmark in a key entertainment area and create a lot of impact, do something to really bring the Italian way that this beer, it's Peroni, as you probably guess, bring this Italian beer to life. So there's a short little video, I'm not sure if the sound's turned up, but a short little video about the cool stuff that we created for these guys. That was on our Taylor Square site, and we built a big moped busting out the front of the billboard. So that just came about after the brief, and got a brainstorm with a bunch of the guys, the production guys, and all the sales guys, and we came up with that cool idea. So yeah, I'm pretty proud of that one. In terms of the future, pretty much anything. Like once you have your foot in the door, I mean, you can go any direction really. Like for me, I could go across to sales in any other media channel. I could go back to agency. I could become an installer if I wanted. Like, I think what most likely, you know, I'll do is probably work in oOh media and work my way up. And at some stage in my career, I'd love to I'd love to head over to New York, the biggest outdoor market in the world, and potentially sell out of home over there. That could be a bit of a challenge, but you never know. As I say, my job's probably not about, like, probably not a job at the moment, the one in 5 years' time, so I'm purely speculating. But yeah, that's pretty much it.
Any questions for Grant? Yep, up back, Jackie.
At any point in your career, when you have these, like, big fights, what you want to do next, do you ever think that you could use the industry and do marketing or finance, or do you always want to stay?
I did think a couple of times about getting into marketing, but I didn't really want to start at the bottom again. But now that I've moved up a bit, like, I probably wouldn't start at the bottom. You'd probably go in somewhere else, like, as, you know, somewhere within the marketing team. But yeah, I definitely did have a few career crises, but, like, I'm in the thing that I love now. So I'd never wanted to do finance though. Definitely not. I got a few buddies in marketing and they love it. Like, I don't think it's dull at all. It's just not my thing. Like, it's just never, once I started at uni, there's little things. I lie when I say I've totally never used it. There's little things that I've taken from my degree and I've applied to certain things, but no, I don't find it dull at all. It's actually quite interesting, like, the way those guys operate. But, and my friends tell me, you know, a couple of guys that I've known all my life who are working at Nestle and Unilever and things like that. No, I think it's quite exciting, but it's just not for me. Yeah.
Anyone else?
Sorry, what would you say would be some of your big break from when you said you were an assistant at Icon? Like, what sort of gave you steps to move up and get really to your next sort of position?
I think being proactive, like, as an assistant, asking your bosses, hey, can I, you know, basically the next step is to buy, essentially. So asking your bosses, hey, can I do that buy, that little regional T buy, B buy, and then show them, hey, I'm killing this, or can I take a couple of those magazine and negotiate that? You know, just trying to put yourself out there and being proactive with the bosses, that pretty much gets your name out there, and they're like, okay, cool, well, this guy's pretty keen. And that's the thing you want to see when you're a manager. You want to see someone keen below you, who's keen to move up and learn and all that kind of thing. So, yeah.
And just buy the right demo, right?
That's right. Yeah. Just buy the right demo.
Yeah. Anyone else? No. What we might do, if it's okay with the speakers, we'll hang around for maybe 5 minutes after.